new lithium sulfur battery breakthrough for EVs. Lithium-ion batteries have been the front runner in battery technology since the early 1990s, powering everything including EVs, large-scale storage, computers, and phones. But as the need for batteries grows, so do concerns regarding the availability of raw materials, battery performance standards, and costs. What if a battery could take all the qualities we appreciate about lithium-ion batteries and increase them? Let's find out. The lithium sulfur battery promises 3 times the energy density at 1/10 of the cost. This intriguing battery technology has laid just out of grasp for many years. Its remarkable chemistry also renders it almost completely useless. At least, it was in the past. This amazing technology may now be within reach thanks to a wholly unintentional discovery. Why all the fuss about lithium sulfur batteries then? Sulfur is a more electrochemically active substance than lithium. It can receive up to 2 electrons per atom at 2.1 volts instead of lithium ion. Lithium ion cathodes have reached energy densities of about 800 watt hours per kilogram and capacities of about 200 milliamp hours. Theoretically, a lithium sulfur battery that uses lithium as the anode, the positive end, and sulfur as the cathode, the negative end, can produce energy densities of up to 2600 watt hours per kilogram. That's more than 3 times a lithium ion battery's energy density. What does this mean for powering your electronics then? You could run your computer over 3 times or get the same amount of runtime with a battery that weighs 3 times less if you switched the lithium-ion battery in your computer to a lithium-sulfur battery of the same weight. Just think about the potential impact on an electric vehicle. The maximum range of today's top-performing lithium-ion-powered EVs is 500 miles. Imagine switching to a lithium-sulfur battery in place of the current lithium-ion battery. A vehicle powered by a battery of the same weight might drive 1,500 miles on a single charge. According to some estimations, a range of up to 2,500 miles may be possible using lithium sulfur batteries, which might enhance energy densities by up to 500%. Furthermore, those are merely conservative figures. You could travel by car from San Diego to Seattle and back on a single charge. In addition to lowering the price of batteries, using sulfur as the cathode material may also lessen some negative effects on certain materials. Sulfur is much more common on Earth than lithium. It is almost as common as iron. Since lithium is used in so many gadgets now and isn't a scarce material, discovering other viable alternatives can only benefit us in the future as battery technology becomes more and more important. Not just for EVs and personal electronics, but also for grid storage. Additionally, sulfur would replace the need for elements like manganese, nickel, and cobalt, elements that raise worries about both the world's supply and humanitarian difficulties. The fact that sulfur is substantially less expensive than almost all other materials now used for batteries, however, is the most compelling argument in favor of using it. For instance, cobalt is a scarce metal, costing about $75,000 per metric ton. However, prices rose by more than 50% in 2021 due to the pandemic that devastated the worldwide supply chain in 2020. Due to an increase in short-term production from $7,000 per metric ton to about $40,000, lithium prices have also increased. But then there's sulfur, whose cost has increased over the same period by about 47%, yet is still incredibly low, weighing in at about $382 per metric ton. In contrast, 200 tons of sulfur may be purchased for 1 ton of cobalt. However, as we already noted, even though lithium sulfur batteries show so much promise, they haven't yet been put into mass production. But all of that could alter due to a revolutionary unintended scientific discovery. It's crucial to remember that EVs are already quite excellent, notwithstanding how fantastic future EVs will be. So, thanks to a complete accident caused by researchers at the College of Engineering at Drexel University, the reality of lithium sulfur batteries may now be within reach. In reality, Dr. Viba Karla and her team were experimenting with various solutions to some of the problems that are frequently connected to lithium sulfur batteries. As we just mentioned, the interaction between the positively charged lithium ions in the sulfur cathode results in all those wonderful advantages. However, The same reaction also has some unfavorable consequences. Chemical deposits known as polysulfides are formed when sulfur undergoes structural changes during the charge-discharge process. Dendrites, which resemble trees, are formed by these deposits and branch up from the lithium anode, deteriorating the anode and the electrolyte. After a relatively small number of cycles, the medium that transports lithium between the anode and the cathode effectively kills the battery. While a conventional lithium-ion battery can be recharged 1,000 to 2,000 times, lithium sulfur batteries only reach their maximum capacity after a much smaller number of cycles. Lithium sulfur batteries wouldn't die in real life until they had been used for a year or two. Using either electrolytes that can dissolve the polysulfides has been one tactic frequently employed to combat the shuttling effect. But these kinds of electrolytes have their drawbacks, including the potential for cost, making them less useful for large-scale applications. They may also be extremely unstable and volatile. Not to add that the amount required to properly solve the shuttling issue could harm the battery's energy density, sort of defeating the point. Dr. Carla's approach was to figure out how to make the batteries work with a carbonate electrolyte that is more suitable for industrial use, similar to that found in most lithium-ion batteries. The experiment involves attempting to confine the sulfur in a carbon nanofiber, trapping the polysulfide to prevent any electrolyte reaction. But the experiment was a failure. Or at least it didn't provide the results that Dr. Carla had anticipated. However, what she and her team found was totally unanticipated. The sulfide stabilized into a very uncommon form known as monoclinic gamma sulfur when combined with the carbon nanofiber. This form of sulfur has a rectangular prism structure consisting of 8 sulfur atoms packed closely together. The problem is that this kind of sulfur rarely remains stable at normal temperatures. In reality, it only occurs naturally in harsh places like oil wells. It is typically only produced in laboratories at extremely high temperatures. Only a few studies in the past century have produced monoclinic gamma sulfur. It has only been made stable for at most 20 or 30 minutes, according to Raul Pai, a doctorate student in the Chemical and Biological Engineering Department and co-author of the study. However, the team was able to build it entirely by accident here in this laboratory setting. So, what exactly makes this discovery so important? It turns out that this particular sulfur form, when crystallized, does not react with the carbonate electrolyte in the same manner as other forms of sulfur would, hence eliminating the polysulfide and the shuttling effect. What does this imply for the efficiency of batteries? The researchers were able to cycle a lithium sulfur battery containing a carbon electrolyte 4,000 times without losing performance, which is equal to using it for 10 years. Additionally, the battery they tested had a 3 times greater capacity than current lithium-ion batteries. So is that it then? Issue resolved? Let's switch the entire theme from batteries to lithium sulfur now. Well, not quite. As with most unintentional discoveries, a team must determine why the experiment resulted as it did. How did this sulfuric phase emerge? Can they duplicate it and guarantee it will remain that way? Therefore, it should go without saying that more research is still required before these batteries may be purchased, but the investigation continues. Utilizing this finding, the team is researching sodium sulfur batteries and other lithium-free battery solutions. Therefore, even though lithium sulfur batteries haven't quite become a reality due to this accidental discovery, they have substantially advanced our understanding of them. So, like the majority of the batteries we discussed, this is one of those that isn't quite ready for use. However, as you may guess, the effects of a battery like this are significant. There are supply issues for every electric vehicle manufacturer. Supply chains for battery materials are just challenging, preventing businesses from producing more EVs. Therefore, a new battery like this one could be quite important, not to mention improved performance and longer life. But diversifying and bringing more diverse elements into the battery supply chain would make a huge difference in adopting large-scale battery storage and electric vehicles. That's it, guys. EVs powered by these sulfur batteries, if it becomes commercialized, let us know your observations and thoughts in the comment section below. If this video was insightful for you, then go on and like this video. Please kindly subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button for more of our updates.